वेलकम वेलकम माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, आई वेलकम यू ऑल। माय सेल्फ प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर राजेंद्र देशपांडे वुड लाइक टू वेलकम यू ऑल इन दिस वीडियो विच इज द टॉपिक ऑफ इम्पॉर्टेंस फॉर द जनरल प्रैक्टिशनर्स, द स्टूडेंट्स, आयुर्वेदिक स्टूडेंट्स हु आर प्रैक्टिसिंग एट द प्राइमरी हेल्थ सेंटर, दैट मीन्स एज ए इंटर्नशिप, एज ए हाउसमैन, and especially the students who are in the third year BAMS, they have the subject Agada Tantra and Vyavahara Ayurveda, that is the Ayurvedic terminology. That means forensic medicine and medical jurisprudence. In this Agada Tantra subject of the third year BAMS, according to CCIM syllabus, this is a very important topic regarding the snake bite, the sarp visha chikitsa varnayata, describe sarp visha chikitsa, snake poisoning treatment. Actually, Sushruta, the great Ayurvedic scientist, has already explained about the sarp visha chikitsa or snake bite. But nowadays there are a lot of what you can say the modern style of treatments or modern established methods of treating the snake bite. So we will discuss today not about the Sushrut but about the modern treatment modalities about the snake bite. So myself is Professor Dr. Rajendra Deshpande. I am MD in Ayurvedic medicine, that is Kaya Chikitsa, and MD in Ayurvedic physiology, that is Kriya Sharir. Kriya Sharir, my WhatsApp number 9226810630. So there are basically two types of the snakes. One category, classification one, neurotoxic, affecting the brain and nerves. Nag, cobra, and maniyar, common crate, are affecting the nerves or the brain. That is neurotoxic. And second, most important, hemotoxic or vasculotoxic. Hemotoxic, related with the bleeding, those are ghonas, russell viper, and furse, that is saw scaled viper. Okay, so here you can see the cobra and common crate. Pictures are always very much fixed in our mind. So this is the picture of poisonous snakes, cobra and common crate, russell viper and saw-scaled viper. These are also poisonous snakes affecting the bleeding problem. Difference between poisonous and non-poisonous snakes. Poisonous are having the head with scales very, very, very small. And in non-poisonous, head scales are large. These five differences you must remember in your medical practice. Even you can teach to the common man how to identify the poisonous and non-poisonous snakes. In poisonous, body scales are large. In non-poisonous, body scales are small and moderate. In poisonous, tail is compressed. In non-poisonous, tail is not compressed. In poisonous, snakes are usually come at night, nocturnal. Non-poisonous, even in the daytime, they can wander. In poisonous snakes, there are bite marks, dunsh, dunk, two frang marks. In non-poisonous, no frang marks, okay? Poisonous snakes, special anatomical features. All poisonous snakes have broad ventral plates on the belly, abdomen, that extend right across from here to here, right to left, whole abdomen, okay? All poisonous snakes have the two fangs, teeth, which really are two prominent teeth besides many other small teeth, big teeth, fangs, okay? Poisonous on the left, my left side, can you see? This is poisonous. This is non-poisonous. About the head, poisonous, non-poisonous. Poisonous across the belly, very large, these plates. And this is not much plates from right to left. Okay, so this is non-poisonous, this is poisonous. Pictures are very important. After bite of snake, a patient bitten by a poisonous snake will always complain of pain over the bitten area. Pain is important. Two fang marks are always seen. The shape of the inverted U. You can see these are the here. One teeth, here another teeth. Like this, fang marks. Bite by poisonous snakes does not all the time should be considered as a serious poisoning. Remember this, because the poisonous or poison containing glands of the snake at the time of the bite, luckily, may be empty. So no poison. Also, even a thin layer of clothing, if you are wearing the sari, if you are wearing the jean pants, full pants, and there is a bite, clothing usually give enough protection. Many times, what happens after bite? Fright. Patient is always very much feared and anxious, and he always thinks that I am going to die. And this causes the panic fainting attack. Watch the symptoms. So what's the duty of a nearby person or a doctor? For example, elapids neurotoxic, that is cobra or crate. What will be the symptoms? Mild burning. Triple response. Three, triple response, redness, swelling, and inflammation. And systematically all over the body, vomiting, giddiness, ptosis. This is very important. This eyelid droops down. Can you see? Here, this is my ptosis on my left eye, ptosis. Can you see? Here my eye is open. Here is ptosis. The upper lid has fallen down. That is called as a ptosis. Ptosis is very, very important in neurotoxic. Difficulty in speaking and swallowing, staggering gait, difficult respiration, difficulty in motor activities like lifting the hands and leg movements, spreading paralysis, ascending from lower limb, convulsions, and death may occur within minutes or even several hours due to respiratory failure. Neurotoxic poisonous snakes. Neurotoxic poisonous snakes. Ptosis is important. Paralysis is important. Respiratory failure for the death. Paralytic stage, number one, I have told you, ptosis. See this ptosis. Don't forget it, ptosis. Difficulty in swallowing, difficulty in respiration. Now next, hemotoxic symptoms of Russell's and saw-scaled viper. Russell viper and saw-scaled viper. What is that? Hemotoxic. Blood is damaged. Local symptoms more severe, more intense pain. Swelling is much more. Cellulitis will be there. Oozing of the bloody serum and formation of blisters and necrosis. Systematically, same vomiting, unconsciousness, intravascular hemolysis, epistaxis, hematuria, blood from the urine, hematemesis, blood, everything bleeding, bleeding, bleeding. Bleeding under skin, like petechy, bleeding from orifices, different orifices, like nose, here, bleeding will start. Hypotension, blood pressure will drop down. Systolic and diastolic, 120/80, normal. In hypotension, systolic blood pressure goes down at nearly 60/40, 70/50. Remember, mm of Hg. Death is because of cardiovascular shock or renal failure. Kidney is going to fail. Snake bite. Can you see? Two fangs. Look carefully. Markings of two fangs, teeth, and then blisters in hemotoxic. Blisters. Okay. When person can die? After bite of elapid. Neurotoxic, 20 minutes. I'm sorry, to 6 hours. And after bite of warfarin, 2 to 4 days. That is neurotoxic. This is hemotoxic. Do not panic. Do not get anxious. Reassure the victim. Don't worry. We will take care. Don't worry. Immobilize the affected part with cardboard, splint, and sticking tape. Seek medical attention. 108 ambulance. Hello, 108. Immediate transfer. Do not pick up the snake or try to trap it. Do not apply a tight bandage around the wound. Do not cut the wound with a knife and blade. Do not suck out the venom. Do not apply ice or immense wound on what in water. Okay. Snake bite management. Snake bite should be treated like a wound. Antibiotic is given to prevent secondary infection and also injection tetanus toxoid. If the patient is completely all right after 6 to 8 hours after the bite, usually the patient is safe. No tosses, no bleeding, no giddiness, no paralysis, everything is okay. After 8 hours, then you are also okay. Snake bite management. To slow the absorption and spread of the poison, patient is asked, do not walk, do not move, do not move. Bitten limb, where the limb means hands or legs, where there is a bite, that part should be immobilized, preferably with splint. Give the splint support. Strip of the cloth or handkerchief or a rubber tourniquet should apply a few centimeters above the bitten area. That particular handkerchief should be released every after 15 minutes for a period of 1 minute. Remember, all the time tight. No. It is just to prevent the spread of the poisons. Tourniquet should not be too tight. It is just to occlude the venous and lymphatic return. Ice may be applied. There is a difference of opinion. In previous slide, I told that no ice. But some specialists, they believe that ice can be applied around the bitten area to control the spread of the poison. So there is a difference of opinion. I'm sorry for that. The wound and the incision can be washed with very dilute solution of KMnO4, potassium permanganate, 3-4 that particular pieces and glass of water, dilute and then wash it. When there is no sign of poison, tablet diazepam, 1 tablet stat as a tranquilizer to relax the mind, to remove the fear, tablet paracetamol as a pain reliever, analgesic. Better not to give aspirin, that can increase the bleeding. Wait and watch for minimum 6 hours to the patient. Number one, you have to see the tosses. Can you see? Neurotoxic tosses. Then local swelling, dysphagia, and difficulty in breathing. Always these are the danger signs. Snake bite management. If paralytic type, there will be tosses. Dysphagia develops. Take immediate action. GP do not have most of the times anti-snake venom. It is available in the government hospitals. So immediately shift the patient to the appropriate hospital, because respiratory paralysis is an emergency. The patient can die. Remember, okay? Neutralize the poison by injection of anti-venom, that is anti-snake venom. This will be the most effective if in the hospital, the patient is shifted and given within four hours of the bite. Time is important. Time is important. Within 4 hours, the injection should be started. Sensitivity test must be done for anti-snake venom. If the patient is not sensitive, no anaphylactic, no allergic reaction of the serum, then slowly that anti-snake venom is injected. Again, this is a difference of opinion. Some people in the olden days, they inject locally around the wound. Nowadays, some people, they say, no, it's not necessary. Avoid local infiltration into a finger or toe. It should not be given into the finger or toe. Anti-snake venom, this is a vial that contains the powder. Dissolve in the 10 ml of sterile water for injection. Give half cc intravenous as a test dose. Watch for 2 minutes for urticaria, rash and itching. If no allergy, inject the full dose. Snake venom anti-serum, that is AS anti-snake venom. Different companies are there. Number one, Vins Bioproducts, Andhra Pradesh, India. Next, Serum Institute of India. Serum Institute of India, it prepares polyvalent anti-snake venom, price rupees 400 for powder to form 10 ml solution. Also available powder by Hofkin Institute, Biopharma Mumbai, 10 ml, rupees 400. Liquid form by Bharat Company, only company which is giving liquid form, Thane Mumbai IV 10 ml vial rupees 400. Now each ml has a capacity neutralizing the venom of falling species of snake. 0.60 milligram of dried Indian cobra venom will be neutralized by 1 ml. 0.45 mg of dried common crate venom will be neutralized by 1 ml of ASV anti-snake venom. 0.60 milligram of dried Russell Piper's venom will be diluted by 1 ml of ASV. 0.45 mg of dried saw-scaled viper, this poison, will be diluted by 1 ml of ASV anti-snake venom. Don't forget this word, anti-snake venom. Administered in two ways, intravenous injection, reconstituted anti-venin is administered by slow intravenous injection, 1 to 2 ml per minute, very, very slow. Infusion, reconstituted anti-venin is diluted in isotonic saline or glucose solution, 5 to 10 ml per kg body weight is given. At present, there is no simple method to measure the amount of circulating venom in the human body, in the patient. So, dose of antivenin cannot be exactly recommended or mentioned. The dose also depends on the type of snake bite and severity of envenomation. Envenomation. Presentation. Snake venom anti-serum ASV is supplied as a free dried powder in glass vials. Okay. Sterile water for injection IP is supplied in 10 ml vials. The antivenin is also supplied as a 10 ml liquid in the glass vials. Disposal. Leftover antivenin and used empty vials should be discarded in a very systematic manner as per the rules and regulations of biomedical waste disposal. Remember this word. Administration. Two vials are usually injected directly by the IV route slowly, 1 to 2 ml per minute, and taking care of sensitivity reaction. Two more vials are given after half an hour to 1 hour if the symptoms of envenomation persist. Further dose can be given with IV fluids till envenomation symptoms subside. Injection atropine 2 ml IV to control excessive salivation and secretions. Injection neostigmine 4 ampules intravenous are given. Anti-snake venom patient should be closely monitored for 2 hours. Now, new research. Local administration of antivenin in or around the bite site is ineffective, may be painful, or may raise intracompartmental pressure, particularly in digits. So nowadays, it is not recommended. What is that? Local administration is not recommended nowadays. Anti-snake venom reactions, anaphylaxis is a life-threatening, fatal type of reaction. Anaphylaxis can be rapid of onset and can deteriorate into life-threatening emergency very quickly. Patient should be monitored closely, and at the first sign of any of the following, that means urticaria rash, antivenin should be stopped. Stop it, because it is fatal. Anaphylaxis, what are the symptoms? Urticaria, itching, pruritus, fever, chills and rigors, vomiting and diarrhea, abdominal cramps, tachycardia, pulse, always look for pulse, hypotension, bronchospasm, respiration problem, angioedema, swelling over the lips, anaphylaxis. What you should do? 0.5 mg of 1 to 1000 dilution adrenaline intramuscular. In children, adrenaline intramuscular 0.01 mg per kg body weight. Anaphylaxis, to provide long-term protection against the anaphylactoid reaction, 100 mg of hydrocortisone, efcorlin or decadron. Then H1 antihistaminics like Avil, injection Avil intravenous to prevent the fatal reaction of anaphylaxis. Children, 0.2 milligram per kg antihistaminic IV and 2 mg per kg of hydrocortisone IV. If the condition is worsening, the patient is dying, a second dose of 0.5 milligram of adrenaline 1 to 1000 IM may be given. Snake bite management associated treatment for the pain, paracetamol is preferable, but aspirin or other NSAIDs should not be given, which can exacerbate excessive bleeding will start. For severe pain, mild opiates, tramadol 50 milligram can be given. Neostigmine is anticholinesterase drug, prolongs the action of acetylcholine, revert the respiratory failure and neurotoxic symptoms. 0.5 mg IM half hourly plus 0.6 mg of atropine IV over an 8-hour period by continuous infusion. For dysphagia, continuous throat suction in the hospital, in respiratory paralysis, endotracheal intubation, artificial respiration, ventilator, total 10 to 15 vials of anti-snake venom may be required in respiratory paralysis after snake bite. Hemolytic type, injection Decatron 2 cc IV stat, injection Avil 1 ampule anti-allergic IV stat, anti-snake venom, 2 to 6 vials intravenous, slowly after sensitivity test, AST. Repeat anti-snake venom if local swelling continues to increase. Repeat clotting time every 4 to 6 hours. Hemolytic type, if edema is very less, then apply electrocrepe bandage. After 6 hours, remove the bandage, watch the skin. If necessary, again apply it. Elevation of the leg, application of around thrombophobe ointment or mega sulf compress. Hemolytic type, when edema becomes severe, skin becomes bluish black, circulation of toes is diminished like a gangrene, then to save the limb, emergency fasciotomy incisions must be taken. Hemolytic type, in advanced cases, we must look for hematuria, blood in the urine, bleeding from other sites like nose, skin, check urine output, everything is important. Hemolytic type, in case of bleeding, blood transfusion can be given. When possible, platelet transfusion can be given. Injection fibrinogen, 300 to 600 milligram intravenous, injection heparin is also given. So my dear friends, today, Professor Deshpande has explained very nicely about Sarp Vishichikitsa for Agadatantra subject 3rd year BAMS. And snake bite concept is very important to understand for the students of Ayurveda when they are working in the hospitals, primary health center. Okay. So I request that whatever I have mentioned, this is an educational video. वैधानिक इशारा डिस्क्लेमर कौनसी भी बीमारी में यथावश्यक यथाकाल वैद्यकीय सलाह लेना बहुत जरूरत है. डू यू वॉन्ट एनी एडवाइस अबाउट एनी हेल्थ प्रॉब्लम ऑनलाइन कंसल्टेशन, यू कैन व्हाट्सएप मी 9226810630. डियर डॉक्टर स्टूडेंट्स, डू यू वॉन्ट एनी हेल्प रिगार्डिंग पीपीटी ऑडियो वीडियो, वी डू दिस पेड सर्विसेस, please WhatsApp me 9226810630. My dear friends, I wish you that you please share this video to your friends, all your WhatsApp groups, like this video, give me support, give me energy, and please subscribe my YouTube channel. I am very much thankful for your nice support all the time. Thank you. Take care. Bye-bye. All the best. All the best to you.